As NATO's heads of state and government have agreed and often reiterate, NATO's nuclear weapons are intended to preserve peace, prevent coercion, and deter aggression. From its inception, NATO's security has been underpinned by nuclear deterrence. In 1953, the United States committed nuclear weapons to NATO, and throughout the Cold War, NATO's nuclear deterrent, as well as the independent nuclear forces of the United States, the United Kingdom, and France, were a powerful part of the alliance's efforts to deter the Soviet Union. Today, nuclear-armed nations such as Russia and China are once again investing heavily to create more sophisticated and diverse nuclear arsenals. North Korea is continuing its nuclear expansion, and Iran is once again making headlines for its nuclear developments. NATO does not seek an arms race, but until our competitors and potential adversaries are ready and willing to forgo nuclear weapons themselves, NATO must be able to deter nuclear threats and respond to nuclear use. This is critical to safeguard the security of the almost 1 billion people who live under the NATO umbrella. So how are we doing that? Well, NATO allies are taking defensive steps to maintain the credibility and effectiveness of our nuclear infrastructure and forces. And we're improving our nuclear decision-making capabilities to ensure a timely and effective response to any threat. NATO works with its allies to monitor and assess recent developments and ensure that its nuclear deterrent remains credible at all times. This means adapting to new challenges posed by potential adversaries and continuously adapting to emerging and disruptive technologies. NATO remains committed to arms control, nonproliferation, and disarmament, but we also continue to make clear that as long as nuclear weapons exist, NATO will remain a nuclear alliance. With increasing challenges to peace and security, NATO still retains nuclear capabilities because nuclear deterrence is still necessary and its principles still work.